Let us now understand Lambert Cosine rule. For this rule, we can write that this rule gives the illuminance of light on a screen due to a point source in any direction. This is the same mathematical expression which we have used in the previous section, that if there is a source S which is having its luminous intensity L in all directions, which we can write as phi by 4 pi if phi is the luminous flux of the source which is emitted in all directions uniformly. Now, at a distance R naught from it, if there is a screen normally placed. In this situation, we have studied that if illuminance of light at the point which is directly normal to the source on the screen, this can be given by L by R naught square. Now, in this situation, if at an angle theta, if we calculate the illuminance of light on the screen at this point, then this illuminance we can write, as we already studied in the previous section, as L cos theta by R square, where R is the distance of the point from the source. Now, this is the relation which we call as Lambert cosine rule, which can also be written as I naught cos theta or I naught prime cos theta, where I naught prime is the maximum normal intensity, maximum normal illuminance at point P due to the source. Due to the source at point P, if a screen is placed in this direction, the illuminance at this point will be given as I naught prime, which is L by R square. Just like in the way we have calculated the illuminance at this point. Now, if I naught prime is the maximum normal illuminance at point P due to the source, then illuminance on a screen which is at an angle theta from that initial normal direction, it can be given as I naught prime cos theta, or it can be written as L cos theta by R square. This is the expression we call as Lambert cosine rule.